Hey folks, it's Rich Mack here, and welcome back to leg number 17 of our Around the World journey. We are in Ostend, Belgium, and we are headed to Verdun, France today. It's the sixth day of this journey, and it is 7:30 a.m. We got a beautiful sunrise here in Belgium. A little cloudy, but not too bad. Generally pretty good conditions. We are at the end of the runway, and we're going to struggle to take off today. I'm really having an issue with the rudder pedals now. I think I'm having trouble making this happen. I'm going to blame myself, because I don't think anything's changed in the last day. So anyhow, let's get started here, and I'll get into that a little bit further. Parking brake released. Let's get out in this runway and get moving. So the aircraft... Takeoff last, by the way. The aircraft has a tendency to pull to the left, and I'm... Come on, let's go. And I'm really struggling now with the rudder sensitivity to keep up with that pull to the left. Either I can't apply enough rudder, or if I apply quote-unquote enough rudder, it jerks me to the right, and then I'm out of control. This is actually my second attempt at taking off here. The first one ended in a brilliant crash because of the rudders. And yes, I am going to blame the rudders. All right, here we go. See if we can do this. Let's make the magic happen. Can't find a happy medium, so I'm jerking back and forth as I'm taking off here, and it's going to happen again, I'm afraid. I see I'm all over the place, and I'm losing it. Let's see if I can just manage this. This is very frustrating. Come on, force it up. Just, there we go. See, that's terrible right now, and I hate to say it, but I'm kind of at a loss as to what to do for it. Did I put no flight director on? Let's go to GPS, and we will set nav, not roll mode. So again, I am expressing my frustration at this whole not being able to configure your peripheral sensitivities thing right now. They've got to get that fixed. In my opinion, it's a little shameful. There hasn't been a hot fix to a patch to get that corrected. Trimming it up here. All right, we'll do autopilot, flight, or vertical speed, I mean. And clean up this aircraft, get my flaps up. I think we're good. That's a cool screenshot. Let's try that. The night lighting in this game is just unbelievable. And I don't fly a lot at night, but the lighting is just crazy good. Yep, we're fine. All right, just want to make sure we were climbing and everything was good. So our destination airport today, Verdun, I think it's actually Sommeville, Verdun, has no charts. I can't find any charts for it, so it's going to be like a true VFR landing there. We'll see how that works. As long as I don't need rudder pedals, I should be fine. I'm so frustrated with that, especially after I had just gotten them all fixed, too. Oh, look at the sun come through. Look at the sun come through. I gotta take screenshots of that. Oh, wait a minute. Come on, sun. That's neat. That is actually one of the first times in this sim I've actually watched the sun rise like that. Seen it on the horizon with that blurred effect. That distorted effect. So while I'm oohing and aahing at that, our flight plan is going to take us right down the, right across Belgium. We'll make a turn to the south. We will just, skirt Luxembourg to the west, and then go back down into northeastern France. As I just punched, oh my God, I just punched my yoke by accident. We go into northeastern France, and then we'll land in Verdun. I can't stop looking at that sunrise. Did it again. Screenshots all over the place. I might descend back down to about 3,000 feet, see if I can get any of these clouds. Can't see anything up in this nonsense. Let's do that. So yeah, right now we're flying pretty much in a southeasterly direction, making a beeline for the Ardennes, and then actually right around Bastogne in Belgium, we'll be making that right turn going south down into Verdun. Am I still up in the clouds? Yeah, all right, we'll go down to 2,500 and just keep an eye out, make sure there's no obstacles in our way. Something tells me those are song lyrics. See some hills up ahead in the distance, so I may be having to increase my altitude shortly. Yeah, I've gotten out of some of that cloud bank now, and visibility's gotten much better, gotten much lighter. So getting out of those clouds and having the sun start to come up. it's been a while since I started to set it up, but when I did set up this around the world flight, I was looking for 150 mile legs, and I was having trouble, if I remember correctly, in this area. This is not exactly a backwoods area of the world, but I was having trouble finding airports. There were several military-ish airports, but I didn't want to use those. Didn't know if I could use, well, I guess in a sim I could use any airport I want, but I was trying to stay fairly realistic, so I didn't want to use any of those. Is that a highway or a canal? Looks like water. It is water. Yeah, I guess that's a canal, huh? So I found this airport, Sommerville, Verdun. And I thought, hey, Verdun, that's kind of cool, you know, the location of the battlefield. But, there's like no charge for this airport, so it's... I mentioned this before in probably all the way back in leg one, but I've flown some of this around-the-world journey already in X-Plane. Actually, I'm almost at a point where I had stopped in X-Plane, because I had stopped when Flight Simulator was coming out, and I figured, you know, why continue in X-Plane? I want to do this all over in Flight Simulator, so I stopped and started it back up in Flight Simulator, and now I've pretty much caught up to where I was in X-Plane. So I did fly this route and landed in Verdun, and it seemed like a decent-sized airport with a paved runway and all, but there were no charts, and I knew that at the time, and I'd kind of forgotten about it, but now here I am in this leg again, and, you know, it's all coming back to me. Hey. Some kind of stadium. Or athletic field. Still have my lights on. Yeah, landing lights and taxi lights do not need to be on. Looks like I'm just going to run into these intermittent cloud banks at 2,500 feet for a while at least. Again, my biggest concern right now is just elevations. I'll have to keep an eye out and make sure there's nothing ahead of me that I slam into. This leg is a little longer, not terribly long. It's about 183 miles, so again, not terribly long, just slightly longer than the 150 I was aiming for. And again, that was just because I was having so much difficulty finding a viable airports in this area. And another thing I wanted to avoid is making it too Eurocentric. I didn't want to just chug my way through the middle of Western Europe. So I kind of skirt around the periphery of Western Europe here without giving away too much of my flight plan, my overall flight plan in advance, but trying to hit more exotic places of the world. And this is a long enough flight as it is at 150-mile leg, so, you know, I didn't want to linger too long in Europe. I love how the sun keeps poking in and out in the clouds. See runway lights off to the right, off in the distance. Not sure what airport that is. I'm looking at the terrain down there. It's looks a lot like Pennsylvania. Can see why a lot of people from this portion of the world settled in Pennsylvania. Looks a lot like what would have been their home. conditions are getting a lot better. There's another runway. So far, it doesn't look like there's anything in my way at 2,500 feet. I think generally the elevation's rising. I started off at sea level, so I just better watch it and make sure that the ground doesn't come up to meet me, but I'm fine right now. Sun's coming up and the lights are starting to turn off. Pretty big highway interchanges down there. I don't see traffic lights anymore. It's also a good effect, a pretty neat effect, how the lights twinkle. Turbulence. So I'm looking on a map right now, trying to get my bearings as to where this airport is. Verdun. It is just to the southeast of southeast of the city, off of the A4 highway. It's like a pretty big, if not one of the biggest highways in the area. Interesting thing is, I'm looking at, actually this is on Google Maps, the area just to the north of the airport, northeast of the airport, is all pixeled out. Looks like it's a, I'm guessing, a French military base. So I don't know how that's going to play out in a sim here if it's all blurred out. Looks like the airport is on maybe a ridge. That's going to be my biggest landmark, is the highway. It is right next to the highway. Pretty much runs parallel with the highway. The highway is zigzaggy there. It kind of has a lot of curves to it, so it's kind of tucked around one of the curves. I'm going to be approaching it from the east. So I'm going to swing around the east of it and then come back in on a westerly direction approach. Got a ways to go yet though. Yeah. Lima Foxtrot Golf Whiskey, that's it, LFGW down there. So when I get to Rensa, I'll be pretty close. Still another 20 minutes. Yeah, looks like most of the lights are coming off now. Getting a little sunlight here. Not much, but a little. I actually thought we were going to be taking a less direct approach, but this is pretty direct, and anyhow, we're not going to go like around the Ardennes. That's going to be off to our left. Probably the hillier area up there. believe that is Morville, Montmédy. Montmédy. Maybe it's pronounced Montmédy. Morville, Montmédy. Charleville-Mézières. That's what it is. That I believe is the Meuse, the River Meuse. And maybe Sedan there. since I'm flying so low, I'm not going to really have to worry too much about descending in. I'm only at 2,500 feet now. Let's see, we're almost at Mensa. Or Rensa. We're not going to a Mensa meeting with all the high IQ people. Gonna stay in here real quick. Gonna see how far it is to Mike Delta. My guess is probably around 9 miles. That's a guess. Let's see how close I am. We're almost there. Oh no, 13.4 miles. It's probably another 16, 17 miles from Mike Delta into Verdun. Maybe if I'm lucky, the runway lights will be on. It'll be lit up. Easier to spot. Cool hills and valleys. Really beautiful, beautiful countryside. Like I said, really reminds me of Pennsylvania. Greenland, Iceland, Scotland. This is the first place that really now reminds me of home. Maybe some those are clouds that were, you know, artifacts of the satellite imagery. Oops. Fields are like building the hillside. Makes you build fields. And let's see, we have another 2 minutes to Mike Delta, and then to start figuring out what I'm going to do here with Verdun. Here for a minute, literally, and see how far I have to go. So as I look at the map, looks like there's going to be a pretty prominent ridge. I think it's a ridge. It's wooded. but the rest of the area is going to be pretty much farmland. There's going to be a wooded ridge that is going to run pretty close to parallel to my flight route, or to my route. And the airport's going to be right where that major highway crosses the ridge just south of Verdun. It should be pretty much the largest town in the area. And I don't know, 21 miles. Man, I'm not good at judging these. So we have about just under 8 minutes to go. Muse just kind of winds its way all the way down. I think I'm going to follow it pretty much all the way down into Verdun. I'm pretty sure this is the Muse. Very windy. Lots of little tributaries branching off of it. As I do get closer, though, I will start to slow down, but not right now. Fine for the moment. This map's really going to help me out. Yeah, maybe. Actually, it might. Especially if I follow the river. So, 16 miles, about 6 minutes. That's my speed. 166 knots. About 8 miles out, I think I'll start slowing down. Actually, I'll do it about 10 miles out. Then when I get in close, I'll be worrying less about slowing down and more about looking for the airport. Sorry, I'm going to bounce back and forth a lot. Yeah, I am just following the Muse right now. Beautiful country. Hard to imagine the horrors it saw over 100 years ago. Out. I might be up on that ridge up there. I mean, I'm heading straight for it. It's kind of far away yet. And I'm looking at it. I'm not looking right down the runway, but perpendicular to it, so it's going to be really difficult to spot a runway.
got to slow down.
All right, so this, I believe, is Verdun coming up right now. Again, the runway should be up on that ridge. And I believe what I'm going to end up doing is hand flying it here in a minute. I'm going to break off to the left so I can approach it from the east. Got the runway setting up already, or runway heading set up in my is that Verdun? Yeah, it's got to be Verdun there. If I can spot it, the big indicator should be the highway. There it is, right there. So what I want to do is, I'm going to take over here, my plane. Let's break off here to the east. I do not want to gain altitude. Now there's another runway up there I can see on the left. That, I believe, was a military airbase. So I didn't choose that. Oh, hang on. Yeah, it's difficult for me to keep control and look around. Look crazy. Go back in. I'm not good at doing that. And we'll do one. And I believe it's that right there. Can't quite zoom in enough. Because it is up on that ridge. Drop gear. Lights are on. Come back over to the left here a little bit. Get a little too close to the runway. Yeah, that's the highway. I'm going to go back over. I'm actually going to circle back around again. I'm going to use the highway as a good reference for myself. I'm actually really low. Once I circle around, it's up on that ridge, so it sits at a higher elevation. Do this to line myself up. There's the highway. Better now. I've got one white. And landing flaps there. Now I'm back in the glide slope. Crosswind left to right. Lights, flaps, gear down. Everything's good. A little low again. Be okay though. Wind is pushing me off to the left or to the right. I'm gonna take this little crooked here. Rudder pedals are gonna love this. Hot. Slow it down. Hot. Nope. Come on. Come on. And I bounce dab. Come on, rudder pedals. Well, we're gonna pretend that didn't happen. Jeez. So now. The pedals are all over. It actually seems worse than it was before. I don't know why. Nothing should have changed, really, but... Come on. Let's turn around. Turn around without going off the runway. Come on. Now we're going to be stuck. There we go. Really need these rudder pedals fixed. Holy smokes. Alright, so that was a really ugly landing. I think I bounced it like 3 times. I had plenty of runway, I was alright with that. But then once I bounced it 3 times, and I was struggling with those rudder pedals and went right off the runway. Yeah, it's that battle trying to give it enough rudder to fight off the pulling to the right there. Man, where's the taxiway? But once I give it enough rudder to fight that, then it just jerks. It just shoots me to the left. So there's no middle ground there. It just makes things really difficult. Really crazy difficult. Maybe I should use more brake. It actually seems to help a little with the brake. I'm just gonna find a general spot right here and stop. Alright, folks. So, not my best flight there. And close, but we got here. Let's go outside. Let's take a look around. Now that I've landed. Now this is Verdun, folks. Again, terrible flight. Had a beautiful sunrise. Actually, the whole flight wasn't terrible, just the landing. Look at that. That's beautiful out there. Your highway is just off to the left here. Yeah, that's the highway right there. And well, anyhow, I hope you enjoyed the flight and hope to see you back for the next one. Thanks.